Hello students, now next examples, find out aromatic and anti-aromatic and non-aromatic given following compounds. Now first one, now take the first example, given structure is this given first compound belongs to aromatic or anti-aromatic, how to identify? So what are the conditions? We know already conditions. First one, what is the first condition? Compound must be cyclic, compound must be cyclic. So given structure is already cyclic, this is cyclic structure, means ring structure. So first condition is satisfied. What about second condition? Conjugation must be present. Given compound having conjugation present or absent. So what I said, conjugation, conjugation means conjugated means what? Double bond, then single bond, then positive charge. That is also conjugation. Double bond, then single bond, then negative charge. That is also satisfy conjugation. Then double bond, then single bond, then lone pair. That is also conjugation. So double bond, then single bond, then double bond, then double bond, then single bond, then double bond, then single bond, then double bond. So these all are conjugation. So compound must be conjugation. Given compound, conjugation is there, conjugation present or absent. So here double bond is there, then single bond is there, then positive charge. So here conjugation is present. Double bond, then single bond, then positive charge. Here four carbons are there. Who? Four carbons are there. Here double bond, then single bond, then positive charge. Double bond, then single bond, then positive charge. So here conjugation also present. Compound must be, what is the condition? Second condition, compound must be conjugated. So second condition also satisfied. These all are conjugation. Conjugation means what? Double bond, then single bond, then positive. Double bond, then single bond, or lone pair, negative charge, or double bond, then single bond, and lone pair also conjugation. Double bond, then single bond, then double bond, then single bond, then double, alternate double bonds. Alternates, double bonds are there, that is also conjugation. So this is a simple trick student, conjugation. And what about third condition? Compound must be planar. Compound must be planar or sp2 hybridization. So generally sp2 hybridization with planar shape. So here each carbon, here four carbons are there, each carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. This carbon also sp2, this carbon also sp2, this carbon also sp2. So here all carbons are undergoes sp2 hybridization. So that's why compound must be planar. So the third condition also satisfied. All carbons undergo sp2 hybridization with planar shape. So that's why third condition also satisfied. What about that fourth condition? Here fourth condition means it must be follow the Haeckel's rule. Here how many pi electrons are there in given compound? Here only one double bond is there, only one double bond, that means only one pi bond. This pi bond having two electrons only, two electrons. So double bond always having only two pi electrons. Once again student, double bond having always only two pi electrons. So in this given compound, in given structure, only two pi electrons are present. If two pi electrons are present, so that's why it is belongs to aromatic. Aromatic compounds contain 2 pi electrons and 6 pi electrons, or 10 pi electrons, or 14 pi electrons, or 18 pi electrons are there. These electrons are these 2 pi electrons, 6 pi electrons, 10 pi electrons, 14 pi electrons, and 18 pi electrons are all are belongs to aromatic, or all belongs to aromatic compound. This is a simple trick student. So first compound belongs to aromatic. What about second compound? At same condition, what is the first condition? Compound must be cyclic. So cyclic, first condition satisfied. What about second condition? Compound must be conjugated. Compound must be conjugated. So what I already explained, conjugation means what? Double, single, double. So like that, double bond is there, then single bond is there, and positive charge. Double, single, positive, conjugation is possible. And lower side also, double bond, then single bond, then negative charge. Here also conjugation. So this complete structure followed the conjugated, the complete structure is conjugated. So here second one also satisfied, second condition also satisfied. So compound must be conjugated, so compound must be conjugated, second condition also satisfied. What about third condition? Third condition means compound must be planar, compound must be planar. So in this compound, here four carbons are there, each and every carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. All carbons are undergoes sp2 hybridization. So sp2 hybridization with planar shape. So third condition also satisfied. What about fourth condition? What about fourth condition? Fourth condition means compound must be follow the Huckel's rule. So here in this given structure, how many pi electrons are there? How many pi electrons? Here a double bond is there, here negative charge, double bond is there, here one negative charge is there. Double bond having only 2 pi electrons, negative charge also having 2 pi electrons. Double bond also 2 pi electrons and negative charge also 2 pi, negative charge also having 2 pi electrons. So in this compound total 4 pi electrons, total 4 pi electrons. In this compound only 4 pi electrons. 4 pi electrons are belongs to anti aromatic. 4 pi electrons are anti aromatic. What are the anti aromatic? That is 4 pi electrons or 8 pi electrons or 12 pi electrons or 16 pi electrons or 20 pi electrons. 20 pi electrons are there. These all are belongs to anti aromatic. These all are belongs to anti aromatic. So here 4 pi is there, belong 4 pi electrons are there, that is anti aromatic. 8 pi electrons belongs to anti aromatic, 12 pi anti aromatic, 16 pi anti aromatic, 20 pi anti aromatic. So this is the simple trick students. Now last one, last example, this compound also belongs to, sorry, what is the condition for compound must be cyclic? It is already cyclic structure is there, this is also cyclic structure. So first condition is satisfied. What about second condition? What is the second condition? Second condition means what? That is compound must be conjugated. Here double bond is there, then single bond, then negative charge, then single bond, then negative charge, then single bond, double bond. So here this complete structure is conjugated. The complete structure is conjugated. Double, single, negative, double, single, negative, double, single, negative charge, then double bond, then single bond, negative charge. So this structure is completed, complete structure is conjugated. Second what is the second condition also satisfied. What about third condition? Third condition means compound must be planar. So in this compound here 4 carbons are there, each carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. All carbons are undergoes sp2 hybridization with planar shape. So third condition also satisfied. What about fourth condition? Fourth condition, what is the fourth condition? Compound must be follow the Huckel's rule. So here according to Huckel's rule, here how many pi electrons are there? Here only one pi bond is there, only one pi bond here, 2 pi electrons, double bond, then single bond and negative charge is there, double, single, then negative charge, here also 2 pi electrons, then negative charge, then single bond, again negative charge, here also 2 pi electrons. So in this compound total 6 pi electrons are present. In this compound total 6 pi electrons are present. 6 pi electrons are belongs to aromatic compound. 6 pi electrons are belongs to aromatic compound. These are the simple tricks students, how to identify aromatic, anti-aromatic and anti-aromatic and non-aromatic. So this is the simple trick students. If you like my video, please like, share and comment. Thank you. And third one is the aromatic compound. So this is the aromatic and anti-aromatic. Thank you.